Lamont can be a pallbearer. We need Lamont as a pallbearer.
We need someone to help push Cheryl.
Filming it for Howard, for H.
Oh, for Howard.
Yeah. Yeah, Junior. I guess I should say Junior, huh? I guess a little confusing from Junior.
And friends, and welcome to Riverside National Cemetery. On behalf of our director and staff, we would like to offer our sincere condolences and thank you for choosing Riverside National Cemetery as your loved one's final resting place. Military honors will be performing rifle volleys, followed by taps, along with the folding and presentation of our nation's flag. For those of you that are sensitive to loud noise, please take the necessary precautions. And for those of you that are able to stand during military honors, please do so and place your right hand over your heart. And for any active duty service men and women or veterans, please render one final hand salute to your fallen brother. Please stand if you are able.
Thank you.
service over to any family or friends that would like to say a few words.
On the 23rd of December, we lost Dad, Grandpa, Great-Grandpa, Howard Sr. It was almost out of the blue, but just a few days to understand that this was not a simple fix, and there wasn't going to be a way to make it this okay. Water technology was, in this instance, a miraculous and wonderful thing. It enabled us, with the kindness and help of Kara, his daughter, to see him, speak to him, be with him at the end. We were able to say all those things that we always assume a person knows that we don't usually voice because it may be awkward. Reminisce about all the times together. We make sure he knew how grateful we were to him for his never-ending patience and kindness. His door was always open. His kids didn't even have to ask. They could just turn up at any time, and he was there for them. Never judgmental, always patient. He lost his first daughter, Wendy, when he was very young and when she was very young. Throughout all the years, right up to the end, he would visit her grave and take care of her. Take her flowers, spend time remembering her, and always kept her in everyone's mind. He stayed close to his wife, Nancy, even though they divorced more than 40 years ago. The two would be there for family gatherings. She would always welcome him in his home. She was always welcome in his home to spend time with children and grandchildren. He will never be accused of being politically correct. He had strong views and opinions, and he wasn't afraid to share them with anyone. If there was a couple of phrases that I can think of that fit this dear man, it would be, he never let those assholes get him down. And he didn't succumb to political correctness. He loved his coffee in the 99-cent store. He didn't believe in waste and would make soup out of leftovers and eat that concoction for a week with some crackers he brought home from lunch. Out and put on the side of in his kitchen. Make do and mend. If it still works, hold on to it. His fridge was always full, no matter whether he was on his own or one or two of his kids were living with him. With all their kids, you'd never see an empty fridge. Nothing made him happier than a good meal with all his family around. He was a kind neighbor, a friendly face, and a regular at the Galleria walking over to have his coffee with every afternoon. He loved dancing and was popular with the ladies. had a twinkle in his eye and a wicked grin. Sense of humor that made the surliest of people smile. If there was one quality he had in life that we should all hope to gain, it would be the ability to close to the end and have no regrets. To know that we have spent our time wisely, to have loved and been loved, to be honest and true to ourselves. If we can look our loved ones in the eye and say goodbye till we meet again, and have a clear heart and soul, knowing those we have left behind will have memories that will hold them, sustain them in the hardest moments, that we can leave knowing all is well and that this is just for a while, then we have done what we were put here to do. Howard Edwin, you were a good man, a loved and revered patriarch of your family. We are proud to belong to you and how grateful we are that there are so many sons and grandsons to carry on your name and posterity. May we do you proud and teach those boys and young men what that name means. God bless you and also us, that we might continue in our lives proving that we deserve the trust you put in us. We have your picture on the wall and your love in our hearts and minds. Goodbye for now. Families are forever. We love from everybody. I echo those feelings and how much I can say. If anybody's welcome, they have a few minutes to come up here and share any thoughts that they'd like to leave at this moment. They can do that.
Well, I remember Monday nights we would all go out for spaghetti dinners and over on the pier in Hermosa Beach. And there's this one evening, I didn't have quite enough money, and he said, don't worry about it. So he paid my way, and ever since then he just kept paying my way, and I tell him, you don't have to do that. And he was very generous and kind to me, and like when my father passed away, he was there for me. When I no longer had my father to ask questions and my father's great wisdom, I had Brother Wood's wisdom. He was smart, intelligent, and wise, and level-headed. And he would never lead you astray in any other direction but straight. His path was in the straight, in the path of righteousness. He was a very good man, and I've known him my whole life. He went to church to my second war. I've known his kids. And actually, we grew up around the corner in the woods. And my brother Lamont, they've been friends forever. And they've done so many things together. And we really have appreciated the woods and their friendship. And God bless you, Brother Wood, wherever you are in heaven.
Say that they didn't know the kind word that he didn't have for anyone around. even church, they say, oh, he's just the nicest person. And I think he's always willing to try to help and reach out to anyone that he could. And I feel like I'm a real better person for having him in my life. And I think the important thing is we have him in our memories and we'll never lose him. And I just want to say thank you.
I'd just like to say how happy I am, how grateful that when we moved in next door 16 years ago, you know, in a world where neighbors often don't know each other, don't get along, don't talk, you know, Howard reached out to us and he became very much a part of our family. And I feel like many of you here are family. You know, I feel like he was closer to us than our own family. Our own family is 2,000 miles away. And we talk to Howard, my wife or I talk to Howard every day. And he was always there, always had your back, always supportive. He was a really good friend. And he'll be very missed. But I'm very happy that he touched our lives and he'll never be forgotten.
Pallbearers to help us.
Thank you.
Thank you, Brian. I would